Here's the deal. Real estate conferences can be pricey. I spent a lot of time going to real estate conferences. I can't ever say I completely wasted money, but I have seen a lot of people do a lot of things that made me wonder, should I put a video out for my audience, for you agents, to understand exactly what you're getting into? Because the truth is, when I started going to real estate conferences, I had no idea. So I'm here to tell you exactly how to make decisions, what to bring, what not to do, so that you can maximize your potential from these real estate conferences, because they can absolutely be business changing and ultimately life changing. So stay tuned. What's up, guys? I am Jeremy Kane with the Real Estate Agent Playbook. Super excited for this one, as I am a huge fan of real estate conferences. I've attended many recently over the years, and I just can't wait to share that information with you. So if you're going to your first one, or you're looking to get maximum value out of the one that you spent money on, you are in the right place. I do videos like this all the time for real estate agents, tutorials, how to grow your business organically through sphere of influence, through social media, and through all the things. I'm here to help you win every single day at the game of real estate. If you like what you hear on this video, please throw me a like. I love engagement. So if you comment, I can promise you that I will comment back, and we can build an entire community around my proposition that says, I am here to help you win every single day at the game of real estate. So without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so first things first is networking and building relationships. Real estate is an absolute relationship focused business. And, you know, I always was that guy that's like, I'm gonna go learn, I know a lot of things, and I don't need to, you know, network with a bunch of people, which is completely counter to how I built my entire business. But after, you know, opening up, having discussions, I learn more from the people that are in the rooms a lot of times than I do from the people on stage. And so you are doing yourself a disservice if you're laser focused on that one speaker, if you're laser focused on the speakers on stage, because ultimately the information that they are handing down, you know, ultimately you probably will take one or two things away, you know, for the overall conference that you actually implement, right? Because people are up there giving all their experience, giving all that information out. And we just want to make sure that we understand that the value is in the room, right? I have some of my very best friends that I have grown relationships with starting at real estate conferences. And this is an absolute game changer, right? When there's agents across the country that you can plug into people. I am a connector by trade. So, you know, just before I was recording this video, I have a friend that I met at a real estate conference. I have another agent in my organization in Atlanta. She has a banger of a listing right now. I connected somebody that I was just recently at a conference with, who actually spoke on stage, but is a good friend of mine. And now my friend from the conference is gonna go meet my agent and film her luxury listing. So that's going to absolutely impact both of their businesses. And that's what I love to do. So in the business, it's not always about, oh, well, you know, who's gonna have a referral that comes to, you know, my city, right? I live in Denver, so it's pretty common to have people move to this area. But you know, say you're in a small town, maybe in Idaho, maybe in Montana, maybe Wyoming, wherever you're at, and you don't go to conferences, or you don't decide to network because you don't think anybody's going to have that one client that's going to move to that small town. Well, there is so much more to gain from these networking opportunities, masterminds, ability to level up. What are you doing? Have you seen this? I'm looking to move, you know, into their market for investment properties. All of these things are specific things that I have already done as a result of meeting people at these conferences. So you got to put your networking cap on. There's plenty of time for dinner, drinks, happy hours, lunch, whatever it is, to really get to know a lot of these people. With that said, a lot of us, especially in the wolf pack, really roll in a pack, right? We roll together. I challenge you that when you're at a conference, try to, certainly, make those connections, continue those connections, build those relationships, but find somebody that you don't know, that's maybe not in that crew that you go with, to, you know, build a relationship. Maybe one a day, maybe five a day, whatever that is, depending on who you're going with and so on. But it's just an opportunity for you to make an individual connection that could change your business forever. No, not by one referral here, one referral there. Certainly that could be a game changer if it's a big one, but more so for the camaraderie, the ideas, the support, all of the things that you can gain from those relationships. So it's a lot more than just the speakers on stage. It's a lot more than just trying to get referrals and make referral partners. There's so much more to gain from the people in that room. And if there's 1,000 people in the room, you need to try and, you know, get to know as many of them as you can. For my introverts out there, I know that sounds crazy, but also you have the opportunity to grab coffee, to grab lunch with a smaller group or one or two people, which maybe is a little more comfortable to you. I just challenge you to really venture out and do that and not be surrounded by the same people that you go to every single conference with. Change it up, network, work the room, as they say, and you will take maximum value just out of the networking piece from these events. Next, obviously, learning from, you know, the industry is best, the keynote speakers, the panels, the workshops, all of the things. But you have a unique opportunity to sit at the front of the room, right? Sit at the front of your ticket level. If you're VIP, get your butt in the front row. If you're, you know, platinum or gold or whatever they call it, get in the front row. If you're general admission, get in the front row. The truth is that you have the opportunity in the hallways and around to meet some of the speakers. Certainly, you know, the president or whoever's there may not be in the hallways, but at this last event, I literally talked and shook hands with almost every person that was on stage, I think with the exception of one, and that was just because it didn't, you know, work out. But I had, you know, the day before, I arrived early, had, you know, an appetizer with a couple of the speakers, had conversations. So be alert, because you never know when you're able to, you know, see those keynote speakers, the people that maybe you follow on Instagram or you listen to their podcasts, and the ability to actually connect with them in person is a lot easier than you think. So make sure that you are being available and being aware, because you can take a lot of things from what they're saying on stage, and obviously that's why you're there, you're taking notes, you're doing the thing, but at the end of it, you know, I challenge you to go through it, and we'll talk about that in a second, but you're only going to take one or two things that are possibly implementable into your business. So while this is super important, the industry partners, the vendors that are there, take this time to meet as many people as you can that might see the world a little bit differently than you, because it can absolutely help your business in one way or another, right? Whether it's vendors, lenders, you know, title company. If you know anything about me or my course, I have an entire pillar on leveraging industry partners. If you're interested in the course, comment course below and I'll absolutely get you that information. But also, once you're really in it, it's really important to make sure that you are making as many of those connections with people that maybe your, you know, heart beats a little bit when you're walking up to, because you're a big fan or this or that. Grab a picture, say hi, introduce yourself, thank them for what they do, what they've done for your life, and you would be surprised at the response you'll get. Next, we talk about a massive opportunity to put your personal brand on display, to create content based on you being, you know, a professional that's looking to advance your career, meeting with other people. So make sure that you're presenting yourself on brand, right? We don't want to, you know, completely be somebody else in our brand. So this is an important piece, and keep this in mind, because people will remember your brand. People will remember your story, especially in the networking side. But understand that, okay, yes, I'm a real estate agent, but I can go to a conference to find out all these investment strategies or, you know, different ways to help me build my business so I can serve you better and all the things. So incorporate that all in your brand. Create that content. You have a massive opportunity for content. At the end, I will talk about things that you should definitely have, and some of them will surprise you. But as we go from there, make sure that you are aware that it's not just like complete vacation, right? If you're a suit and tie guy, don't show up in flip-flops and shorts, right? I show up in flip-flops and shorts and polos, so that's what you get at conferences. But as you go, understand that it's a massive opportunity to build your brand and surround yourself with people that are like you. So that's my favorite part there. Next, I want to talk about the goal setting piece. And I actually went to this last conference, the Atlas Alliance Summit. I just did a video on it last week, 10 takeaways. Go check it out. It was absolutely life-changing for somebody that's been to many conferences. If the Atlas Alliance Summit happens in 2025, I better see you there. But I created a GPT. If you want access to that GPT, comment GPT below and I'll absolutely give it to you. It'll walk you through exactly this. After the conference on the airplane, I went through all my notes. I took how I was feeling that day, how I was feeling the next day, wrote all these notes. What I ended up doing is going through my notes one last time and talking about exactly what I needed to do. I made a 7-step process that I took from this event. The beauty of that event, if you watch the video, was that the Atlas Alliance is based on core values, much like my business, much like a lot of other, you know, people's businesses, much like the Wolfpack is going. We're going to implement some core values into there because I love this idea so much. Create those core values. Everything goes in through those core values. This entire event was based on speakers that were pouring into these core values and all of the things. But if you can start a business from core values, you can absolutely make every single decision. Your business will never infiltrate your personal life if you're sticking to those core values and so on. So I created this 7-step process that starts with core values, goes through morning routines, goes through all your pillars of business, and absolutely gives you an outline or a business model to really take forward. And that's exactly what I took from this last conference, as you saw in that video. So again, if you want that, it'll ask you all the questions. The bot will walk you through it all. It'll ask you exact specific questions. As I went through my 7-step process, it'll ask you those same questions and build you an outline that you will absolutely fall in love with, and it'll absolutely change the game, even if you do have core values. I'm a guy, I have core values right here. I've updated it. I've gone through it after this event using this GPT, and it is absolutely life-changing. So if the event's life-changing, you can create something from the notes, from your takeaways that is life-changing. That's when implementation happens. And so, again, if you want that, comment below. But this is something that I do. You walk through, you take notes, you know, your main takeaways, maybe some goals, maybe your mindset shift, because you are so pumped up, right? The energy from the event, the energy from the rooms, the energy from the speakers, you take forward in your business and in your family life and everything you do. But we have to bottle that and capture it so that we don't have to pay, you know, $2,000 to travel across the country to go to these events every single day, right? So bottle some of that up, take it away, get your main takeaways, and absolutely dial those in. And then you also have all your people. You can network, you can tag them in social media as you go through the process of defragmenting from the event. Definitely, if there was impact, connect with those people, message those people, reach out and thank them. Whatever it is, you're able to do that, right? I've connected with almost all of the speakers based on, you know, following them on social media and all of those things, just because as I go through the day-to-day life, I'm running into things and I'm sharing their posts or, you know, whatever that, you know, had the impact on me. So finally, what to bring to the event. This is a big one. First and foremost, business cards. A lot of people use social media as their business card now. Totally cool. Virtual business cards are awesome because you can make that switch a little bit quicker. And if you're still old school, sometimes it's nice to just pull out a card and throw it out there. Sometimes we as real estate agents struggle to get those into databases and things, so that might not be as lasting as the other. Next is comfortable shoes. Usually a lot of walking at these big venues, getting to different conference rooms, getting here and there. It's a long day, so make sure you have comfortable shoes. Could be 3 days, could be two, one, whatever. Always go for comfort if you know me. Water, immune boosters, right? I'm not sick, actually. I just talk too much to the camera. But, you know, something like that. I use something called Aconitum that every time I get sick, bam, it hits me. I'm ready to go. So a lot of that, a lot of people use emergency, whatever it is, to kind of keep that immune system up, because hopefully you're shaking a lot of hands, talking to a lot of people, and spreading a lot of germs. So make sure that you're taking care of that. Water does the trick as well. So make sure you're staying hydrated. Next thing is like a coat or a sweater, cardigan, whatever it is, whatever matches your brand, whatever matches your outfits, because these rooms are so big and so full of people. Sometimes even in the wintertime, they're pumping these ACs into there and it does get a little chilly, so dress in layers if you can. Hopefully that doesn't mess up your vibe too much, but definitely I've seen, you know, actually my good friend Nicole throws events and she talks about the smartest thing she ever did was, you know, get blankets that were branded to the event because they are a hit and people look for them every single year, which is kind of crazy. Next is obviously your phone, your lapel mic, whatever, recording content, taking videos, taking pictures with people. You can create some banger content, you know, reels and things like that in your stories, all the things, allows you to tag and again, you know, get a little bit closer to those speakers, those people that are, you know, quote unquote untouchable, which they are not at real estate conferences. So that's super important. A lapel mic, if you want to talk about it, talk about your experience, talk about the game changing, you know, whatever. Start with accountability, right? If you're making a promise to yourself that, hey, this is what we're going to do, this is what we're doing at this event, right? You can create that content. If you have that lapel mic and you're a video guy like me, that's absolutely game changing. So the tech stuff is crucial. I'm still not there yet where I have a video crew following me around at events, but someday hopefully that happens. But there's all kinds of content that you can garner from these events. People put a lot of money into these productions, into these, you know, lights and stages and things like that, so that you can have the opportunity to absolutely create, you know, content that is amazing, next level, that is really beneficial to your audience and so on. So make sure that you are prepared for that. Next is a variety of clothes. I've already talked about this a little bit in the branding, but business casual, business formal, and casual. There's a lot of different, you know, things that you do. Maybe you're going to a formal dinner because you're at the VIP dinner. Maybe the next night you're going out, you know, on the town and it's, you know, you don't want to be walking around Nashville in a sports coat like I did the first day at that last event because we went from a formal dinner to downtown. But lots of opportunities to do different things. So make sure that you are prepared for what is to come, because as you know, sometimes at these events, people like going to these fancy dancy restaurants and sometimes you can't get in there in your beach gear. So I would definitely suggest looking into it, but also just planning to have a variety of dress codes as you go through these different events. And the next, bring an open mind, connect, learn some things, take notes, and then at the end, absolutely defragment, put it all on the table, write it out, you know, type it out, whatever you have to do, listen to it, anything you can do to relive that moment. Make sure you're, you know, paring your notes down, because when people are on stage, we're writing really quickly, and make an outline or take something from each and every single thing you do, because you paid good money to be there. Again, if you want that GPT, comment GPT. You don't even have to be at the event. It'll walk you through exactly the steps. It'll talk about different things that the people talked about, but I just wanted to bring that to you as part of my moving forward and my takeaways from the last event I was at. So make sure you're following up, you're implementing, and at the end of the day, do not waste your money unless you are ready to make game-changing decisions at conferences, right? Make sure that you can make those life adjustments. Make sure that you are ready. You're open-minded. You are not the best realtor on the planet, nor am I. So that's exactly the mindset that I go into it with. I can learn something from the agent that's on stage that's never sold a house, never come to my town, never done anything. I can learn something from that person on stage, or I can learn something from that brand new agent or that experienced agent sitting right next to me. So it's all about connection. It's all about taking as much as you can, being a sponge. And if you do these things, I promise you, you will absolutely not feel like you waste $1. I don't care if you paid for the double VIP or the GA, you will absolutely make life-changing decisions at events. So I hope this helps. If you have any questions, let me know. Leave a comment. Tell me what's the best real estate event you have ever been to below, and I would be happy to engage, and hopefully I can help you with your business. Hopefully this helps you get a win someday in the real estate game. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.